Hey everyone, Danny Webster here for Pocketnow.com, and this is the software review of the Samsung Galaxy Note, a cross between an Android tablet and an Android smartphone. So let's get to the software. So the Samsung Galaxy Note comes bundled with some pretty great software. Some of it is a combination between tablet and smartphone software. So let's just check out some of the widgets, and I can either use my S Pen or I can use my finger to just tap and hold, and I can view the widgets down here. So I have all these widgets that come stock on the Galaxy Note, and I can go through some of them here. Let's just choose simple clock, and I'll add a simple clock up here. And let's say that I wanted to add something else. Let's just choose something. Let's choose a picture frame, and we can add that. It'll add it. I can select the images that I want, and I hit OK. So now I can view the pictures, then they will display a slideshow on my device on the home screen. I have 7 home screens to choose from, and I can view some of my favorite people up here, so I can add them, so I can quickly click on one of them and it will begin calling, or I can send messages or whatnot. I can view my calendar, which is pretty neat because there is a widget directly on your home screen. And I also have, let me just go back here, I also have my S Memo little widget right here, so I can view that and I can begin writing. So let's just say I wanted to write, "Hey, how are you?" Okay, so I can do that, and I can save it directly to my, my Galaxy Note, and I can view the memo right here on the home screen. So some neat features about the S Pen is it has a secondary button, and it will cause different actions. So let's say that I wanted to view the menu, all I have to do is hold down the secondary button and slide the S Pen up. If I want to get rid of it, all I have to do is go back, hold the S Pen, and just slide over to the left. So this is pretty cool. You can also take screenshots of on any application or any program that you're using. Just tap and hold, and it will take a screenshot of whatever is on the screen. So then I can just go back home, and I can view that screenshot if I'd like. So let's go into some of the applications, and these are some apps that I've installed, and you can view the applications. Most of them come standard on most Samsung devices. So here I have the S Planner, which is my calendar, and it's pretty cool because if I turn it to the side, I get a tablet-like interface. I can just click this button here and I can view the week. I can scroll back and I can view the year if I'd like, and it's a pretty nice feature to have such a large calendar on any smartphone. So we can just go back. We can go into the camera. So the camera works really well, and we can go into the settings and change some things. We can have self-portrait, which turns on the 2-megapixel front-facing camera. We can have all these different shooting modes, so let me go here. I can have a smile shot, beauty, panorama, which is a nice thing that a lot of Samsung phones come with. We can just go back. Let's say that we wanted to add some effects. We can do that, and I can just have it turn into a negative, and there we have a negative effect. I don't know if I have anything too interesting around here to take a photo of, but you can see it's a negative effect. We can just go back, and it also does record in 1080p video. We have Social Hub, which allows us to integrate our Facebook, Twitter, and other social networking sites directly onto the Galaxy Note. So here I can view some of the messages from either Facebook or from Twitter, so I can view some of these. If I want, I can do other actions by clicking on here. I can reply, retweet, favorite, and also message this person. And I can also view my messages. We can view Music Hub, which allows us to download music that's either featured or some of the best music available at this time. So let's say I wanted to view some of the top tracks and just click on there. And now if I like one of these songs, I can purchase it directly from the Galaxy Note. Reader's Hub allows you to view your magazines and newspapers as well as your books directly from the Galaxy Note, and the reading experience is pretty nice on such a large display. Of course, this is a 5.3-inch WXGA resolution screen, so you won't have any eye strain when trying to read a small print or whatnot. So after the newspaper has been downloaded directly to my Galaxy Note, I can either listen to the articles or I can also click on them to read them. So let me just click on here. We can listen to this, and some of the articles have been read aloud, so we can listen to them directly from our device.
Nobody goes quietly in New York. Movement's 2-month anniversary.
And it will show us some of the headlines, and I can also just click back to view the newspaper itself. Just click on here, and we can pinch to zoom, and we can pan. Another really cool feature about the S Pen is the ability to take notes on any application. So all I have to do is hold down the secondary button and double tap, and it will bring up a menu. This is the S Menu Lite, and I can just take a note here. So let's say I wanted to write down something. So read rest of paper, and now I can save it, and it will save it as a note directly onto the Galaxy Note, of course. So the video quality on the Galaxy Note is phenomenal, and if I click on here, I can watch one of the videos. Because the screen is a Super AMOLED HD display, the colors are absolutely crisp in comparison to other LCDs out there, so we'll just go a little bit faster. Let's see here. So the screen is absolutely clear. You have to realize that this is the same number of pixels that is on the Galaxy Tab 10.1 and also the Samsung Galaxy Tab 7-inch screen. So fit into a 5-inch display, it's amazing how crisp the pixels are, and the pixel density is very large, in comparison to the size of the screen. So we'll just go back. All Share is a great feature that comes on many Samsung devices. What this application allows you to do is to view videos, photos, and also listen to music through a network connection. So let's say you're in another room and you want to listen to some music or watch a video. All you have to do is connect to your remote device here, and I connect to my network drive, and it will load in just a second. Okay, so now this video is being streamed over my network connection directly to the Galaxy Note, and of course it is pretty clear, and it doesn't buffer too much in comparison to other media players because the processor is so fast on this device. If you used a Samsung device in the past, most likely you've used keys to sync up all the content on your Android device. So here we can click on there, and if I want, I can view directly, I can view all the files on my Galaxy Note by going to this address on the browser of my computer, and let me just click stop, and there we can just go back out of this application. Because the S Pen does use Wacom technology, it allows you to have pressure variances on various screen gestures. So let me just go onto Photo Editor, and here if I want to write on this particular photo, let me just go down to the settings here. And now I can begin writing, and if you see I write something very light, it shows a very thin line. And there we go. And if I want to have a thicker line, I can press even harder. And that's great if you're an artist or you just want to jot down something or even create something pretty simple. So I can also erase it here. Let me just erase this. I can change the colors by going to this menu, and I can select different colors and also different writing utensils. Let me change the thickness. And if I want to have it red, I can go like that. And I can try to make it very thin on this one. And if I want, I can also make it thick. So thin and thick. So there we go. It's kind of simple, and it does work very well with the S Pen. You can also use your finger, but of course you don't have the same pressure control that you would have with the S Pen. Video Maker is probably one of the best video editing applications that I've seen on any smartphone or tablet device. So let's say I wanted to make a video. So all I have to do is click on one of these. Let's choose a movie. It'll select this. I can also choose between other things. So I can just click there. We'll click Apply. So if I want to add a video to my timeline, all I have to do is tap and hold and drag it down to the timeline. And here I can scroll through the video itself. I can go up here, I can add photos if I like. So let me just add a photo. Let me say I wanted to add a photo there. Come on now. I can just drag and hold and drop it into this segment here. I can add an audio track. I can also add other photos and videos directly from the camera, so I can record right now and edit the photo directly as I'm recording it. I can edit it as I'm recording it, so I can just click done, and I can preview the video. And you can add different transitions and different effects. You can change the lighting features by going down here. You can add text. You can do so many things with this video editing application on the Movie Maker. Mini Diary allows you to keep a journal on your Galaxy Note. So if you want, you can just add a photo here. I can choose something from the S menu, or I can choose something from the gallery or the camera. So I'm just gonna skip all this. If I wanna add a location, I'll just click on there. It'll bring up my current location, and I can just tap this and say done. So if I want to add text, I can just go right here. Another great thing about the Galaxy Note is it does have writing recognition. So if I wanted to say hello, of course, I'm not a very good writer. I have horrible, horrible penmanship. That is why I prefer to type on a computer. So as you can see, it was still able to recognize what I was trying to say. And so I can click done, and then I can, it will just automatically save itself. I can just save it here as well, and it will save it onto my diary. Samsung Apps allows you to download, of course, Samsung apps for free directly onto your Galaxy Notes. Let me just accept this. I just updated that particular version of the Samsung apps. We'll click OK. So I can click on the top apps, and as you can see, all of these applications are free. So even Angry Birds Seasons and Angry Birds Rio is free. I'm not sure if those are the ad supported versions or not, but we can also go to more and view some other applications that are free directly from the Samsung apps. With the included headset installed to the 3.5mm headphone jack, I can go to the FM radio and uses this headphone set as an antenna so I can listen to music and whatnot directly from the radio. So let me just scan through a few channels. So there I can listen to that station if I'd like, either through the headphones itself or through the speaker, and I can also change the alternate frequency. I can scan and add my own favorite channels directly to this FM radio. Polaris Office is a full-featured office application that allows you to create your own documents, or you can also search either through the device memory itself or through your SD cards. So let me just click on here, and let's say I want to add a document. All I have to do is click on one of these. And here I can also use the writing utility if I like, or I can just type using the keyboard, and the keyboard works really well. It is kind of big, so sometimes I've noticed that I have to use two hands in order to send a text message or to enter document information. Crayon Physics is a game that comes pre-installed on the Galaxy Note, so let me just zoom in for a second, and we can just skip all this stuff here, and we can continue our game. So now if I want, I can just click on here, and the object of this game, of course, is to use various tools or whatnot to get this circle over to the star. So if I want, I can just draw on the screen, and if I'm able to do that, let me see if I can knock something down here. So I want to bump the circle all the way over to the star, and you get the idea of how to play this game. If you're looking for applications that work well with the S Pen, the S Choice ties into the Samsung apps and has all these other free applications available to download that use the S Pen or pretty much a drawing or sketching type of application. So I can just click out of there. So another nice feature about the Galaxy Note is it does have the voice controls that we've seen on the Galaxy S2. So I'll actually just double tap the home screen, and then I can use voice controls, memo. Make sure to pick up some milk and some eggs from Fred Meyer. So there it was able to recognize my voice, and then I can just save it directly to my Galaxy Note. And I have all these other actions that I can control, or I can just say, hi, Galaxy. And I can just go back to this main screen here and select something that I can input through my voice. So the Galaxy Note is an unlocked GSM device, so I can access AT&T 3G and HSPA Plus up to 21 megabits per second speeds. Right now I'm toggling between 3G and HSPA Plus, so let's just begin a speed test and we can see how fast this device is able to access the network speeds on AT&T, and right now just switched back to HSPA Plus. So I've been getting around 6.7, 6.5 megabits per second download speed and around 2 megabits per second upload speed. So we can just allow this to finish, and it looks as though it's going pretty fast, so it's not too bad. So we can view the previous results right here, and this is in the greater Seattle area. So you can see most of the speed tests are around 6.5, 6.7 download, around 2 up. So the Galaxy Note also has features that allows you to use the gyroscope. So if I want, all I have to do is hold two fingers down, and I can zoom in and zoom out by tilting the device. And there's many other actions that are available, and I'll post those in the final review coming up next. So the Galaxy Note also has a great email application. It's kind of similar to a tablet device in the sense that you have your inbox over here and you have a preview of your message right here. So I can just click on this and I can view my Facebook message or whatnot or whatever message I have in my inbox. In the applications menu, we can also add folders to some of our favorite applications so we can organize our application screens. We can go down here and change some of our most used applications and features on the Galaxy Note. So let me just go back. I can also change it to a list view so it will show me all the applications that I have in an alphabetical order from the list view. Because this is an unlocked Android device, we can access Wi-Fi hotspots directly from our wireless and network. So if I want, I can just go to tethering and portable hotspots, and we can use this as a Wi-Fi hotspot through a 3G connection. The live wallpapers that are included are here, and we can view some of those, and they're pretty similar to the other ones that we've seen on other Samsung devices. So here's all the live wallpapers that are included. So this has been the software review of the Samsung Galaxy Note, and if you like our videos, make sure you give us a thumbs up and also leave some comments down below. The Samsung Galaxy Note is running Android 2.3 Gingerbread and will be upgraded to Android 4.0 Ice Cream Sandwich in 2012. If you want to get more information about the Samsung Galaxy Note, visit the link in the description directtopocketnow.com, and you can also check out the unboxing video right about here. I'll post a link, and the hardware review right about here. And the final review will be coming up next. Thanks for watching.